If you can count me out, I'm counting my bullets, I'm loading my clips, I'm writing down names, I'm making a list, I'm checking it twice and I'm getting them hit. The real ones been dying, the fake ones is lit, the game is off balance, I'm back on my shit. The Bentley is dirty, my sneakers is dirty, but that's how I like it, you all on my dick. I just poured something in my cup. I've been wanting something I can feel. Promise I am never letting up. Money in your palm don't make you real. Foot is on their neck, I got them stuck. I'ma give them something they can feel.
Hey YouTube, welcome back to my channel. Today is Timeline Tuesday and I'm excited because normally for Timeline Tuesday, I do these on my Instagram and they're not as elaborate as today's going to be, but I usually just kind of show my timeline and show like the edit and allow people to see the end result as well as the timeline at the same time so they can kind of go along with it. But today I wanted to do an in-depth tutorial on different effects that I use for this video. Now, Kalana is my main client and a lot of people love the effects and the videos that I do for her. We've been doing this since last year and most of the questions that I get are on her videos and the effects and transitions that I use for her video. And so I wanted to give you guys an in-depth tutorial of how I create her videos. Everything I do is strictly in Adobe Premiere Pro. I don't go outside of Adobe Premiere Pro to get any effects. Everything I do in Adobe Premiere Pro. Outside of that, I also have a class, an editing class that I am teaching. So if you want to get more in-depth than this tutorial, then make sure you go and check my class out. It's a one-on-one class that I teach. And so if there's specific things that you want to learn, or if you're a beginner and you don't even know where to start and you want to get to this place where I'm about to show you now, make sure that you sign up for my class. I only offer 5 classes a month, and so definitely check that out. But we're gonna jump right into it because I want you guys to get this. I'm going to go in and we're going to get this thing started. So the first effect I did, as you can see, you get this kind of mirrored effect in a sense. It's like a ghost effect that kind of pops up on her, and so I'm gonna show you how I did that. So let me loop this so that we can be able to focus solely on that. Oh, it's already on there. So we're gonna loop. So you see that ghost effect. So basically the way that I did this is C016 is the actual clip. As you can see in the source monitor, it's the original clip. So what I did was I just duplicated the clip. Let's see. And I don't need this. D3. So. Okay. So the first way I did is I duplicated the clip, which is I'll unenable these clips. And to unenable, you just click enable and it'll turn them all off. So as you can see, this is the first clip. I duplicated it. And option drag basically allows you to duplicate the clip, and all I did is frame by frame towards the end based off the beat I cut the clip, and I got rid of the beginning so that you can see the original clip, and then every other frame towards the end I got rid of. So now you see the 3 on top of each other. All I did for this clip to be able to see it, because you don't see it right now, is I just went to the blend mode, which is on the left hand side, and I just clicked on lighten, and you still don't see it. So what I did was I moved the position over so you can see now that ghost effect, and I basically copied the full effect and put it on the other two. And in order to copy and just kind of put it on the rest of them, and so you don't have to do it one by one, you just right click, you hit copy, and then you select the 2 clips that you want and you hit paste attributes. That's gonna bring up this panel and you see where it says scale attributes. So I only want to affect the motion, and we're also gonna hit opacity. So because the opacity is where the blending mode is. And so we hit okay. And now you see all 3 of them have the ghost effect. So That's how you saw that effect that I did at the beginning. So moving on, we kind of just show more of the outfit and then we cut and we do this mirrored effect. And you still have to remember, all these effects are really, really fast because she likes like quick, fast-paced cuts. So and the next effect that I did was I duplicated the clip. And then all I did was I went to my effects where you actually get your effects and I just typed in mirror. And this is all in Adobe. I didn't go outside of Adobe or anything like that. Everything is in Adobe. And I just dragged mirror over to the top effect, the duplicated clip. So you don't see the effect now. You never will. Whenever you drag an effect on top of a clip, you never will see it until you animate it and keyframe it and, you know, do whatever needs to be done to actually see the clip. So for this effect, all I did was I played the with the reflection center. And because you don't see it, you have to bring the center over until you see it. So I just brought the center over. And this is like four frames, so it's going to go really fast. So when you watch it, it kind of creates like an effect because it's such a fast clip. The next thing that I did was you see these three kind of, they're the same clips laid on top of each other. And then I scaled them down so you can kind of see the background, which is just black. All I did for that was basically the clip was 100. I scaled it down to 50%, as you see over here. And I just moved the position from the center over to the left. And in order for them to come on at the same time, I went two frames to the right and I basically duplicated the clip and did the same thing and just positioned it up a little higher. And then the next clip, which is the same clip, I did the same exact thing and kept it in the center. And so because they start two frames after each other, when you watch it, they kind of just basically come in right behind each other. And that was all I did for that clip. After we cut, we show it again and we move to the next outfit, which is just a quick cut. And then we show that outfit and then we start to get into the effects for that outfit. So with this one, I just basically wanted to kind of just show all three, just do something quick. And all I did for that, which it looks complicated, but it's really not. I duplicated the clip, so they're all say C017, and I kind of, and they're all sped up, that's why you see the 125%, but for this, let me bring it down some more, all I did was, I duplicated each clip, as you can see, so all I did was scoot it over where you see a little bit of the back of the clip, and then it starts to get into like the threefold of her. And with that, all I did was move the clip over. So originally without the crop, I just moved it. It was centered. I moved it over to where I felt like she would be on the clip underneath. And then I added a crop feature to where I can see her. And it was about 37%. And now you see two of her. And I feathered it also to where it's not a super sharp and distinct cut. But I feathered it to like 212, which made it seem like it was all in one clip. But it's not. So when you see it go really fast, she's going to kind of pop in the second person. And then it's going to go back to her alone. And then did the same thing for the left side, which she pops in on a different side. And then now you see all three. So that's kind of what I did for that. So she comes in, she scoots over, she pops up, you see her by herself, she pops up again on the other side, and then she pops up again on the right side, and now you just see all three. And that was just scaling and cropping to where you can see all three clips, because if you didn't crop, then the only clip basically that you would see is, yeah, so this is how it would look if I didn't crop. But because I did crop, I cut off the unnecessary pieces that I needed to see all three of her. All right, so the next one with her is this. I really played around with this. So with this effect, all I did, we're still on the same outfit, but I duplicated it three times. So, well, I duplicated the clip. This is all one clip, and I cut it up to where I felt like time-wise, I wanted to add the effects. So the first way I did it is when I duplicated the clip, I really just the clip under it is 219. Originally, it would be 100, and the position would be centered. But I made it bigger to where you just see the outfit, and then the clip on top, the duplicated clip, I scaled it down to 58. So behind it, you see the outfit, but then like this small center section, you see the full clip. I did that for about four frames, so it's gonna go really fast. And then I cut that clip and made it a little bigger. So now it's at 84. So it goes to 58 to 84. And then the last one, you just see behind because I cut it and all I did was have it zoomed in. Again, everything is in Premiere. I went to my scale and my rotation. I started it at one, so that's why you only see this little dot right here, and the rotation's at zero. By the time I get to the end, it's at 87 and I rotated it 131. So when you watch it fast, at the regular speed, it goes like this. And so when you watch the full thing that we have so far, it's gonna be.
You can count me out, I'm counting my bullets, I'm loading. You can count me out, I'm counting my bullets, I'm loading.
So everything's really fast. We're only 3 seconds in. We're about 3 seconds in. Everything, well, two seconds in. Everything's super fast. And as you can tell, all the cuts are on beat, right? So that's why when I'm cutting these things and adding these effects, we want it to pop with the beat. That's the way it's more extravagant. That's how you get that, like, dang, like this is dope. Because the beat, if you cut to the beat, it just adds a flavor. So you always want to make sure, for me at least, I'm an editor that cuts to the beat, especially with videos like this where you want it to just be a hit, right? So you want the beat, you want it to just blow up and pop. So I cut to the beat.
You can count me out, I'm counting my bullets, I'm loading.
So, after that, we go to the next effect. And this effect, I kind of cheated. This effect, I actually did take from online. It was a free effect. And all it is was, let me show you. It's basically a color mat of like five, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. 11, like 11 colors, and I did take this online, but I will show you how you can actually do it. The way you can create this in Premiere is you just go to New Color Mat and you make sure that the video settings are right, which, and then basically you pick your color and then you will title it whatever color that it is. And so, what you do is when you go to your project and then you go to your footage, you'll see red. And basically, you create 10, 5, however many colors you want, and you put them all together, and you can nest the sequence to where it kind of just flows like this. Because these are about 2 seconds. I mean, 2 frames. Some of them are one frame. But all I did was add the blending mode to difference. To now you see her, which is the original clip under it, and it kind of creates this like really cool changing color effect. And that's all I did for that effect. It's pretty cool that everything is in Premiere. Like I said, I did take this, but you can literally do the same thing in Premiere, which whoever created it probably did it in Premiere. That's how easy it is. It only takes like 5 seconds to do. And then I just went back to this original clip. I scaled it up 159, didn't do anything to it, just scaled it up. And then we go back to showing her, and then you see the glitch effect, which the glitch effect I talked previously a year ago, my favorite way to do it. I know a lot of people buy these presets and a lot of people go and buy other people's glitch effects, but it's so easy to do. And like, you can check out my other video on how I did it. This effect is in Premiere Pro and you don't have to go outside, you don't have to spend your money to buy it. But I basically just got an adjustment layer, and it's about 2 frames each to just end it and move to the next outfit, so it's a transition, but I just added the glitch effect on top of it, on top of the regular clip, as an adjustment layer. And I play with the POI scale, and I play with the POI aspect, and the master amplitude, and I put it at 100. So originally without it, it's like this. And then with it, I just basically added the effect. I didn't, you know, keyframe it to make it do all this stuff because it's only 2 frames. So you're going to see it and it's going to go away. I did add the random speed at 9, which originally it's 0. And I copied it and pasted it the same for each. And under it, as it does that, you see that it morphs into a different clip. So it's like a transition that goes from one outfit to the next. And you don't focus on it because you focus so much on the glitch. So, so it literally, you don't even tell that it switches clips, but it does. So we're on a whole new outfit. Yay, we're almost done. And so with this outfit, I really just kind of like wanted to kind of slow down the effects and just kind of like bring you back. So for this one, all I did was I duplicated the, actually I have 2 different clips. One is the clip of her full outfit, which I positioned over to the left, and then I put a b-roll of, because like I said, we always get b-roll of like the different designer logos and the shoes and, you know, things like that. And so I put that on the right hand side, and I just cropped it. I cropped it to 24 so that you could, I mean, I cropped it so that you could see her outfit on the left. And I just center cropped it. And so now you see both. So it just kind of cuts and just shows that. So that's a super simple effect. Next, this is a pretty cool effect that I used. This was my second time using this effect. But all I did was to the original clip, I added magnify. And this one can go. So I added magnify, and then basically I did it as a square. You can do it as a circle. I did it as a square. And guys, this is all in 4K. I just choose to edit on a fourth, because if you edit on a full, sometimes it can slow down your computer. So yeah, I just basically started the center off at the top of her head, and as you go down to the clip, it just focuses on, go all the way down to her shoe. And that's really all I did. So that was pretty cool. Super simple. It's in Premiere. It's called Magnify. You can start the center wherever you want, and it basically just kind of focuses and highlights whatever you wanted to highlight. The next effect was at the original clip, I put offset. So originally it's like that. And then I basically played with the offset, moved it over. Again, this is only like a couple of frames. It's about 4 frames. So even though you feel like it doesn't do anything, and it looks weird, when you add it all together as a full cut, you'll see why everything makes sense. So don't focus on just like the look right now. Just focus on the fact that it's going to go from this clip to this clip to this clip to this clip, right? So in its entirety, it becomes like a banging hit. But by itself, you're like, well, that doesn't make sense. Why did you do that? This clip, all I did was I went to Fine Edges. And like I said, it's all in Premiere. So I just typed in Fine Edges. And I just put it on there. I didn't do anything with it. I just put it on there, and it created this look. So without it, that's the original clip. With it, it created this look. It's only about 3 frames, so it goes really fast. So it creates an effect. And then the next one, I came back and did the same thing with magnify. I made it a lot bigger, so it covers her full body. And then, of course, I did the paint effect, which is one of my other favorite effects. So I did that, and I did color and alpha. If you want, you can kind of play with it. But I did color and alpha. And then you can stroke it if you want, to where it kind of looks like a stroke. Like, you know how people do those strokes where they outline the person, or they like write words onto the video? You can do it that way if you want. But I just kind of wanted to like fill up her body in a sense a little bit. So it just kind of adds a little motion to it. And I have a tutorial as well on my YouTube about how I play around with this effect. And then I did that for a while. And then I did the same thing, and I just duplicated the clip. scaled it down so you and added the glitch effect, which if you go to the beginning of the video, you see I added the glitch effect. So I've already used that. I've already used the paint tool. So I'm kind of just reusing these things in different ways. So now when you watch the full thing of what we've done so far, we'll go. You can count me out. I'm counting my bullets. I'm loading my clips. I'm writing their names. I'm making a list. I'm checking it. And that's, you see it's all to the beat. So it goes really fast. Now it's starting to make sense to you. You're like, oh, okay, that's dope. I see it. I get it. But when you're doing these clips individually, you're like, what? So you always have to know your end game. And I always know the end game because I've worked with Kalana for a lot of these videos. And so I know what she wants. I know how creative she wants them to be. I know how many effects that she wants. And she just wants it to look super dope. So, moving on. This is the last outfit. And so you see the outfit. And then we go to the first effect. The first effect for this is replicate. I've used this before in a lot of her videos. So with this effect, I just added the replicate on top of it. And it created four rows, four columns across, four rows down. And I didn't animate it or anything. So this is kind of what you get. It's only about three frames. The next effect, I duplicated the clip, added a screen. So originally it was, I also scaled it up. So it's 126 as compared to 100. So it's a little bigger. And then I added a screen. So because it's bigger, you kind of see if I wanted to animate this, I could make her kind of, the ghost kind of like come out and make it bigger. But I only, that's only three frames. So it's going to go fast. So it's going to just pop up and then go away. This clip, I duplicated it and I did the same as I did at the beginning where I like cut for each frame. Each one of these, as you can see, is just a frame. And that is a different clip. So originally the clip is the full outfit and then I went and got the B-roll, the close-up of, you know, her skirt. And all I did for those was add difference. So for each one, I added their difference. And so it kind of just kind of comes on screen for a frame and goes away. The next clip, I basically just added a color balance. So if you go to color balance, HLS, I played around with the hues. So I went from blue all the way to like purple. And then I added this like super cool effect. And how I did that was I duplicated the clip and I added mosaic on top of it. So it goes from the colors to this trippy effect, which I love this effect. I just added this trippy effect, which is called mosaic. I played around with the horizontal blocks to see what it would give me. And I keyframe those to add the effect to go from extreme to not so extreme to create a transition that will ultimately go into this crazy wavy effect. And the way I did the wavy effect was I duplicated the clip and on top I added wave warp, which is in Premiere. And so all I did was I kind of played around with it, but I started at 105, 40 direction is 90, and the wave speed is 1. And from there, I bumped up the direction, and I bumped up the height, and I bumped up the width. So basically to create from vertical to more horizontal effects. So so let's see how that looks. Because he's like, the real one's been, and it's kind of like a little slower. So it's the transition is following how he's rapping. So that's why that wave makes sense. So just listen to how he says it and then see how the wave kind of like flows with how he says it. So that was pretty cool. And then we basically just go into this four panel that we do for all of her videos, which I basically scale each one at 51 and move them all to create this not even effect, but really just putting them all to where you can see all four clips. So I basically stacked them, and then if I wanted, I could have nested the sequence, but we'd had it to where on set, she turned at the exact same time. And so basically you see these markers, even though they're not straight, but I wanted to get it to where all the turns are at the exact same time. And then we just basically go into actually going to show how she puts on the outfits, the close-up of the outfits and things like that. So you'll see she puts on the first outfit. We show the designer, and then I do this effect, which I have this tutorial as well on my YouTube. Really, you just scaling the clips down. I show you three different ways to use this clip. Make sure you check out my tutorial. But basically, each one is scaled down to where you see the clip underneath it. And then she goes through. She puts on the next outfit. This is all sped up. And for this, as you go back to the beginning of this video, you see I just scaled these down, showed the background, and kind of moved them to where you kind of see both. And these are all just simple cuts of the details of her outfits. And then you keep going. She's putting on more clothes. And then we cut to more details of the next outfit. And then I do like a little flash. And with that, all I did was I duplicated the clip. I inverted it, actually. So without the invert, it's the regular clip. I inverted it, and I did that twice. So you basically see how it kind of like goes super bright and goes back to create an effect. And then you see the last outfit that she puts on. And she shows it. She shows the shoes again. The fear of God. We got a shot of the back of the shoe. And that's it. And then we cut to a title card. So I'm going to show you guys again how this all played out after you've learned all the effects that I used for this video. You'll see the end result and how it all makes sense. So we're gonna render it.
If you can count me out, I'm counting my bullets, I'm loading my clips, I'm writing down names, I'm making a list, I'm checking it twice and I'm getting them hit. The real ones been dying, the fake ones is lit, the game is off balance, I'm back on my shit. The Bentley is dirty, my sneakers is dirty, but that's how I like it, you all on my dick. I just poured something in my cup. I've been wanting something I can feel. Promise I am never letting up. Money in your palm don't make you real. Foot is on their neck, I got them stuck. I'ma give them something they can feel.
So that is an in-depth tutorial on this video I did for Kalana. Like I said, we do a lot of these. We do like at least try to do two per month. And those are the effects that I used. All of these effects are in Adobe Premiere. You don't necessarily have to go outside of Premiere to create these effects, which is great, especially if you're a beginner and you just want to learn about Premiere. Play around with the effects, see what you get, learn your timing, how fast, how slow things need to be, how things look. But that's basically how I edited this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Share this video with people, your friends, your other friends who are video editors, whatever. Share this video. I would love to get to 1,000 subscribers if possible. I also have an online class as well. I also sell shirts. You can check out my website, BrittneyJanae.com. And I'm just trying to do it. I'm just trying to help other women, video editors, get into this. And so we're out here and I'm excited about this. So make sure you like this. Make sure you share this. And make sure that you subscribe. And I'll see you guys soon on another Tuesday. Thank you and have a great day.